No, I didn't think so. If you did, I'm sorry. We're going to anyways. The last piece we played was, of course, a John Philip Sousa march. He is one of the most famous march composers of all time, and the one that we just played for you was dedicated to the officers and the men of the 311th Cavalry. John Philip Sousa himself was a devoted horseman and rider, leading him to purchase a beautiful black Arabian steed called Aladdin. No magic servant hid this horse through him and messed up his right shoulder. This caused him to adopt the familiar conducting style in which he swung his arm from the elbow rather than the shoulder, and that piece was entitled Saber and Spurs. The next tune we're going to play for you comes from Rodgers and Hammerstein musical Sound of Music. This is Edelweiss. Thank you very much for coming out again tonight and supporting us all season long. My name is Michael Chula. If you didn't know that already, I am filling in for Linda Becker. That's if you enjoyed the music tonight and this whole season. If not, my name is Linda Becker. And as usual, there are various concessions, including hot dogs, water, Gatorade, Freezy Pops, pretzels, and brats being served at the concession stand from the Cub Scouts. And as always, popcorn from Haven. So please support both of those great organizations. In addition to that, as usual, our roadies are going around helping you purchase your 50-50 raffle tickets for the end of the concert. And this week we have a lot of prizes to give away in addition to the 50-50 raffle ticket. So unlike a campaign or a voting, I would like you to buy raffle tickets early and often. Probably shouldn't vote like that though. The next tune we're going to play is an oldie but a goodie. This is American Patrol. For the next tune, written by Frank Cofield, we'd like to feature the clarinet section on this one. This one is called Clarinet's Allegro. Thank you. I don't know how this one escaped us on a Pirates concert, but this one was written by Captain Alfred H. Miles and Chaz A. Zimmerman. And this is an arrangement by James Poyer. This is Anchors Away. And I know as a conductor of a community band, I'm not supposed to talk about politics, so I apologize this, but of all the armed forces service songs, this one is absolutely my favorite. I just enjoy it so much. It is a terrific one. If that offended anybody, I apologize ahead of time. Just a reminder, there are various concessions, including hot dogs, water, Gatorade, pretzels, brats, and Freezy Pops available from Cub Scouts, unless there's not any more of them and they ran out. Otherwise, they're still there. And popcorn, as usual, from Haven, so please feast. And also, don't forget to get your 50-50 raffle tickets from our roadies who are wandering around right now. If you think of a very famous dance, you probably think it's a polka. And we're not going to play a polka for you. The next tune we're going to play for you is a tango. It is entitled Blue Tango, and it's usually what comes to people's heads when they think, okay, there's got to be a tango involved someplace, and this is the song that jumps in everybody's head. This is written by Leroy Anderson. Thank you. Our next tune we're going to play is a jazz tune written by Warren Barker. This one's entitled Foggy River Blues. Pretend I didn't say anything. The band nearly mutinied on me. That'd be a first. The next tune we're going to play is not Foggy River Blues. That's going to be after this tune. This tune harkens back to a time when all you wanted to do was stay in a field and play with your 9 other friends, and one of you would be pitching and one of you would be batting, and this of course refers to Take Me Out to the Ball Game, the unofficial anthem of baseball. The next piece needs no introduction because I already gave it to you. Thank you. Funeral March of a Marionette was written by Charles Gould, and it's a very famous tune that you will probably recognize if you've remembered the old Alfred Hitchcock Presents, because this is used as the theme for that TV show.
Thank you.
There's several famous march composers. John Philip Sousa is obviously the most recognizable one, but oftentimes underrated is Carl L. King. And Carl L. King is known for writing lots of marches, including circus marches. And we will be playing a tune for you. This is entitled Miss Liberty. The next tune we're going to play for you requires some audience participation. Okay, and I am going to show you what you need to do for the next thing. Okay, you need to take one hand or two hands, and with your fingers you need to snap like this, twice. Because the next tune we're going to play is the Addams Family theme, and I'm sure you'll know where to put your snaps in.
Thank you.
written by Irvin Coleman and made famous by Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass. Our next tune is Miss Frenchie Brown. I told the band this earlier. Linda has provided me lots of scripts, and I couldn't think if that was because I went off script too much last week or not. I haven't read any of them yet, but this one's got a lot of good information. So, born in Racine to Italian immigrant parents, the conductor of our next tune named Frank Bescrisuto, was the director of bands and professor of music at the University of Minnesota for 32 years. He instituted the Indoor Marching Band Concert at Northrop Auditorium, and it's since been copied by many universities and even high school bands nationwide, including Madison. So if you go down at the end of the year, or the end of the concert year, they always have the Indoor Madison Band. This piece has been performed in a tour that was a 7-week, 10-city, 27-concert tour in the Soviet Union as a cultural exchange concert with the Bolshoi Ballet. The next piece we're going to play for you is entitled Latina. Famous song titles named after states. Can anybody think of any?
Oklahoma.
If you said Oklahoma, you would be right. That's what we're playing next. Oklahoma. Feel free to sing along. The words are Oklahoma. The next tune we're going to play is actually a medley of two tunes written by one of my favorite composers. He is a movie composer, and whenever I introduce this to young or introduce him to young bands, I always say he could have never possibly won every Academy Award he is nominated for. And I ask students why, and we come up with the idea. And it's because John Williams has been nominated several years, I think 3 years, where he's been nominated twice for the same category of Academy Awards, and he could only have won it one time, because if he wins one, he would have lost the other, obviously. This is probably his two most famous tunes. This is the Star Wars theme and Raiders March from Indiana Jones. Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, get those raffle tickets out. And as you're getting out, I'd like to just take this opportunity again to thank you for coming out tonight. You've been a terrific audience. We're glad that you came out. And we want, it's starting to get a little dark over there because there's, that's not going to rain. Don't worry about it. But we will be back here next week at 7 p.m. And we look forward to seeing all of your beautiful faces here. And now I would like to raffle off. We have lots of things to raffle off, so be prepared. I should be prepared. So our prizes are collections of gift certificates and coupons to different community organizations here in town. And a big round of applause to all of the people that have donated to it. They include Miller Furniture, Take 5 Oil Change, ExxonMobil, Napa Auto Parts, the Eagles Club, McDonald's, and the Golden Harvest Market, and a few other things. We have baskets and other things to raffle off. Hargraves donated a flashlight to us, and also a Cut Above donated a hair care basket. So we are donating all of that, and how about a big round of applause to all of the people. So here we go. Better get all of this stuff ready. And how about, I'm sorry, how about a big round of applause for our roadies that have been doing all this work? Alrighty, the first ticket is 452-0103. If that's your ticket, stand up and say, hooray! 452-0103. Where? Right on over here. Huzzah, yay! The next winning ticket is not a golden ticket, it's a white ticket. Some of you might be thinking they're all white tickets. They are. 451-9650 right here. There we go. The next prize goes to the lucky person with ticket 451-9706. Once again, 451-9706, if that's you. Oh, right on over here. The next winning ticket is 451-9763. Don't worry, we got two more prizes before the 50-50 raffle. Whoa! We're giving away a flashlight right now, so if the storm's coming and it gets too dark, you're gonna have lots of friends because you will be the only person that has a light to shine the way to your car. But it's not gonna rain, don't worry. The winning ticket number is 451-9794. 451-9794. And one fabulous hair care basket to the person who holds ticket number 451-9725. 451 9725. I heard from David that we are giving away $170 today, so someone there is going home $170. Thank you very much for your contributions. The winning ticket is 451-9727. 451-9727. The next tune we're going to play for you, written by Irving Berlin, needs no introduction, so I'll keep it short and sweet. This is God Bless America. And we may play a piece after that. Thank you.
bomb.